Luxriot Evo is a comprehensive surveillance ecosystem suitable for video management systems of any size. Using Evo products, it is equally easy to deploy a small office CCTV and an enterprise system consisting of multiple sites and thousands of devices. In this video, we shall overview the basic Evo functionality as well as take a look at some of the integrations it has to offer. Evo Client is very user-friendly and very intuitive. From the Resources panel on the left, simply double-click or drag and drop the desired items onto the viewports. When you have arranged the items on one or multiple displays, save them as layouts, either locally or share them with other users. The video in each viewport contains overlay controls, small buttons in the corner. These allow you to access various channel-related functions. For example, you can use pan, tilt and zoom, and also PTZ presets and tours from here. Using the overlay control buttons, you can instantly create snapshots and bookmarks, switch between high and low quality live streams, and listen to the incoming audio and talk back to the camera. For each individual channel, it is also possible to set the aspect ratio of the picture, which will be later saved with the layout. For the cameras which do not have a motorized lens, digital PTZ is available with a picture-in-picture preview. This mode also supports D-Warp for the fisheye cameras. Just as with the regular PTZ presets, you can save the digital PTZ positions, which will be later loaded together with the layout. Your layout will appear in the Resources panel, alongside with the layout template, empty grids used as a base for your layouts. You can either use the built-in ones or create your own. Local and shared layouts can be combined to create autoplay sequences for video walls and workstations. The Live View tab also features instant playback. Review the last recorded footage while still preserving the live feeds from other channels. In this mode, you can instantly create snapshots and bookmarks, export video, and switch to the full featured playback whenever required. Here in the Playback tab, you can view the recordings from one or multiple channels simultaneously at high speeds in both directions. You can also browse the timeline by jumping back and forth, frame by frame, minute by minute, jump to the very beginning or end of the archive, and switch between motion events. When you have found the time of interest, simply select it and then export the selection with a single click. For faster archive navigation, the Playback tab also features the calendar. The months, days, or periods of time which do contain video footage are highlighted blue for your convenience. Apart from live video, the Live View also has maps. Maps are either based on images, like building plans or aerial shots, or created using the built-in geographical map. The maps have interactive markers for different kinds of resources. For example, you can lock and unlock doors, pop up video from one or multiple cameras, also trigger actions related to software buttons, and switch to other maps. Apart from the instant playback and multi-channel playback, there are also advanced modes for the archive investigation. You can quickly switch to those tabs directly from the Live View. The Smart Search mode helps you navigate the archive based on motion events. You can define the area of interest or run the search for the whole frame. The motion threshold refines the results. The lower the threshold, the more separate small events you will get. With higher threshold, the results are glued together for longer chunks of video. You can export the video from here and also export the search results into a CSV format. Another helpful search mode is sequencing. Instead of watching hours and hours of recordings, even on high speed, use Sequence Explorer to break the video into a series of scenes. Thus, you can quickly find the object of interest, even when the video does not have any metadata. So, instead of usual playback, we use sequencing here and break the video into smaller and smaller scenes to quickly find where the change has taken place. After you have found this scene of interest, you can either export it as a snapshot or as a short video, and you can also quickly switch to the full screen playback to see what was happening in that scene. You can then switch between playback and Sequence Explorer for efficient investigation. The Sequence Explorer tab will remember your last position in the archive and will preserve it until you exit the application. To further facilitate the forensic search, Evo offers an opportunity to create bookmarks at any point. These small tags on the timeline can have different severity levels and can be also created from the client application or automatically based on some internal events. When browsing the bookmarks in the Playback tab, you can search based on the bookmark time or on the bookmark creation time and also select the severity levels of interest. Evo can also store data in the form of counters. These may be events from the video analytics or any internal events. For example, we can count how many times the door was opened or how many times the motion happened during a specific time. Using those counters, it is further possible to build graphical reports. The reporting tool allows you to select the chart type, the aggregation options, and of course the time range. After you have created a graphical report in the client application, you can export it in PDF format for further use. If such reports are of regular interest, it is also possible to program Evo to send those reports built automatically on a daily, weekly, or monthly basis. The reports exported from the client application will be stored in the library section, alongside with all the exported snapshots and videos. Luxriot Evo software has multiple integrations with external systems. One of these is the license plate recognition module. The recognition results arrive with the live stream and are available in the notification area, with an option to instantly playback the moment of recognition. Additionally, there is a separate tab for the license plate recognition investigation called LPR. To run the search, select the channel in the resources panel on the left, then specify the search parameters on the right and hit the search button. Similarly to the smart search mode, you will have a configurable grid containing the output and the clickable list with the results on the right. From here, you can add tags for creating black and white lists and also export the list of the results into the comma-separated value format. The face recognition integration is similar to ANPR. The live recognition results are available in the notification area, with an option to quickly switch to the full-featured playback. The Face Recognition tab allows for forensic search amongst facial recognition events. Similarly to LPR, also select the channel, then specify the search parameters. You can search based on the time and also based on the tags for subjects which are already in your database. Also, you can prepare pictures containing faces of interest to base your search on an image. After loading the picture, simply draw the area of interest over the picture so that the face is highlighted red. Then adjust the search interval and the accuracy, and then hit search. Browse the list and click the results to quickly switch to them in the preview grid. From the previews in the grid, create bookmarks, switch to the playback mode, or export videos with a single click. As you might have guessed, at this point you can also export the list of the results into a comma-separated value format. Evo supports a number of third-party access control systems, such as Kiri, Phoenix, Gallagher, or Roger X5. The integration is two-way, and this allows us to both receive the events from the access control system and interact with its nodes, for example, lock and unlock doors from the Evo interface. There is a separate tab for access control, which allows you to browse the access control events based on their source or time interval. If there are video channels associated with the access control doors, you will also see them in here, and you'll have the list of doors and list of all available cardholders. And last but not least, Evo features a powerful tool for implementing automated scenarios called Event and Action Configurator. All you need to do is simply create all the desired events and the results of these events, called actions, and combine them into rules. The rules also have configurable options and schedules. For example, you want to receive emails about motion in the specific restricted area only during weekends or during nights. Software buttons can be also extensively used for those scenarios, for example, for triggering emergency recording for any number of channels. In this example here, the user button, when clicked, initiates the emergency recording and also notifies the client with a pop-up window. Evo offers a wide range of actions available for configuration. That includes switching between recording profiles, different logging, interactions with cameras, for example, send camera to PTZ preset or send audio to the camera and play back there, send events to the client application in the form of different notifications, send SNMP traps, send emails with or without snapshots, and others. The configurator helps you automate the daily routine and make sure you receive all the necessary important notifications.